shame. And I love that old cross where the dearest and best for a world of lost sinners was slain. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. Till my trophies I will cling to the old rugged cross. Till my trophies I will cling and exchange it some. I will ever be true. Its shame and reproach gladly bear. Then he'll call me someday to my home far away. Then he'll wear his glory someday
forever. you are wise, and there is no other God like you and beside you. You are awesome in all your ways, and your splendor is beyond human comprehension. Lord, forgive us for the times when we have sinned against you, for the times when we have fallen short of your glory, for the times when we have planned, O God, to do wrong. Forgive us, God, and we confess, and we pray, Lord, that you will purge us and make us clean. We thank you for the gift of salvation, and we thank you for Jesus Christ, who died that we might live. We thank you for this opportunity of worship, the freedom of worship, and we invite your presence here with us today. And God, as we come in this time of worship, we come remembering those who stand in need of our prayers and stand in need of your touch. Remember Sister Lydia Ross, Charmaine Gilead, Rose Claire Josiah, Shauna Rissing, Damaris Bradshaw, Dora Wrigley, Nellery Newton Saki, Shermel Brown, Claudina Barnard, Janine McDonald, Glendina Isaac, Cynthia Van Beverhood Harris, Winifred Violinus, Maria Phillip, Diane Hobson, Cheryl Milliner, Joy Joseph, Andrea Francis Drew, Ann Martin, Viola Benjamin, Heather Isaac, Janet Francis, Amelia Joseph, Namari Nelson, and remember our brothers Vernon Drew, John Jonas, Morris Benjamin, Thomas Christian, Henry Sobrati III, Jonathan Francis, Ralston Davis, Desmond Phillip, Courtroy Jarvis, Charlo Christian, Morris Francis, Alfred Josiah, Austin Rowland Jr., Dennis Lynch, Roderick Arthur, Steve Williams, Frederick Mohammed, Frederick Joseph, and Aidan Stevens. And Lord, we also remember all the children baptized in this church, our acolytes in this conference, the joint board, our pastors, our conference, the PEC, and our province. We pray, O Lord, for the government and leadership of these United States Virgin Islands. Remember those actively involved in the Russia-Ukraine conflict, the Israeli-Palestine and Gaza conflicts, all institutions of learning. Remember the bereaved and all those who stand in need of our prayers, our brothers and sisters, our family and friends in neighboring islands and even on the mainland. And Lord, if there are those persons whom we may not know of, who need your touch and our prayers now, we remember them before you. But God, as we pray for others, we also pray for ourselves and ask, O God, that you will strengthen us for the daily fight with sin, that you will give us the grace and the courage we need to live for you each day. So come amongst us in this time of worship and bless us as we seek to declare your goodness and your faithfulness to the world. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Our hymn of praise, He is risen, He is risen. Tell it out with joyful voice. Let's stand as we sing. We confess our faith today using the confession of faith number one. I believe in the one only God, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, who created all things and was in Christ reconciling the world to himself. I believe in God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who chose us in him before the foundation of the world, who delivered us out of the power of darkness and has translated us in the kingdom of the Son of his love, who has blessed us in every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places in Christ, who made us meet to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints in light, having foreordained us unto adoption as sons through Jesus Christ unto himself, according to the good pleasure of his will, to the praise of the glory of his grace, which he freely bestowed on us in the beloved. I believe in the only begotten Son of God, by whom are all things and we through him, who became flesh and dwelt among us, and took on him the form of a servant, Jesus of Nazareth, the Son of Man. He was tempted in all points like as we are, yet without sin. He spoke that which he did know, and bore witness of that which he had seen. As many as received him, to them gave he the right to become children of God. Behold the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried, and the third day rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sits at the right hand of the Father, from whence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. This is my Lord who redeemed me, purchased and gained me from sin, from death, and from the power of the devil, not with gold or silver, but with his holy precious blood, and with his innocent suffering and dying, to the end that I should be his own, and in his kingdom live under him, and serve him in eternal righteousness, innocence, and happiness, even as he, being risen from the dead, live and reigns world without end. I believe in the Holy Ghost, who proceeds from the Father, and whom our Lord Jesus Christ sent after he went away, that he should be our comforter and abide with us forever, that he should help our infirmity and make intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered, that he should bear witness with our spirit that we are children of God and teach us to cry, Abba, Father, that he should shed abroad in our hearts the love of God and make our bodies his holy temple, and that he should work in us the will of God, dividing his gifts to each one even as he will.
Amen.
To God be glory in the church which is in Christ Jesus, the holy universal Christian church, in the communion of saints and at all times and from eternity to eternity.
Amen.
Amen. You may be seated, my sisters and brothers. My brothers and sisters, good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
This is the day that the Lord has made. We will and say it like you really mean it. This is the day that the Lord hath made. We will and be glad. If you are happy to be alive this morning and in the house of God one more time, he's allowed us to come together one more time. Amen. Before I forget, I bring you greetings from Jamaica, man, where I spent a few days last week and the week before. I attended the Synod of the Moravian Church in Jamaica, and I felt like I was a celebrity at one time, because this guy came up to me and says, I've been dying to meet you. And I went, huh? He says, yes, I watch you every Sunday. I said, but how could you watch me every Sunday? He said, because our church is 11, which is 12 o'clock for us. So he watches us before he goes to church and comes back. Alvin, I want you to know that you have fans in Jamaica, right? Because they come and tell me, I just love to hear the organ in your church. And they watch me every Sunday. So I want us to know, Friedensberg, that we have a membership in Jamaica as well. But I bring you greetings. And they tell me to tell them hello. And if it wasn't for a visa, I'd have done reach. So, they want to go. But it's good to see you all, and it's good to be back with you as we come together. It's a rainy day, a rainy couple of days, but we give God thanks for how God is blessing us. Amen? Amen. Do we have anyone visiting with us today? To our social media members, we're glad to have you as well. Any visitors today? I don't see any, I think. So, oh yes, I do. I'm sorry, we do have one. Please stand and share with us your name and where you are worshiping from.
I'm Zamrin Tomlin from Jamaica.
Yes. Let me give you the story about Sister Tomlin now. So I go to Jamaica, right? And one person said to me, "You're from St. Croix?" I said, "Yes." "There's a lady named Zamrin Tomlin." I said, "Where do I know that name?" I said, "Yes, Malcolm's mummy from Bethabara." Correct.
Yes.
Yes, Sister Zamrin. Welcome back to you. We haven't seen you in a while.
Thank you.
I want you to know that I bring back the Easter bun and I bring back the hard dough bread. Okay. And my son and I are fighting over the hard dough bread. So I'm eating it one slice at a time. I just want you to know, and that every morning I had dumpling, green banana, sweet potato, and yam for breakfast. Every morning. I just want you to know, Sister Tomlin, that I came back and my surface is a little tight this morning. But it is because I eat all that hard food that you Jamaicans gave me at Bethlehem. But it's good to have you, Sister Tomlin. Welcome back.
Thank
and it's
you.
Good to see you. I kid you not, every morning was this hard food. And it made matters worse. Bethlehem Moravian College, where the synod was held, they have a farm. So they grow a lot of what they eat. And they were cooking. So they grew a lot of sweet potatoes. So every meal, we had boiled sweet potato, raw sweet potato salad. We had sweet potato everything. So every day you get sweet potato in some farm. And every day you got this green food, this green banana, so because they grew it right there and cut it and brought it for us. So every day, so I'm a little fat now because Sister Tomlin people, I wasn't fat before. I was pleasingly plump. Now, but what are you? With me fat now because... Let's take our welcome. Let's think, the one bad experience I had at Bethlehem, though, is that it was cold. I did not expect it to be that cold. So my voice is now coming back. But it was cold. When I tell you it was cold, the Tuesday morning when I got up, I was smoking, because it was that cold. It was 60-something degrees the morning. It was cold, and then by the night, the breeze was blowing. It felt like 50-something degrees, and my voice went with the breeze, too. I had no voice for most of my time there. I didn't expect it to be that cold, but it was a good experience, but it made cold. And I wasn't in Bethabara, where Sister Tomlin is from, because Mandeville, Manchester is cold up in the part of there. But it made cold up in the hills of Malvern. Very, very, it wasn't cold, it made cold up there, so. But it's good to be back where it's warm. We welcome you to Friedensberg. Let's sing our welcome song. We welcome you to Friedensberg. We're welcome in this place.
Yeah.
celebrate now with those who are celebrating a birthday throughout this week. I'm celebrating tomorrow, Brother Darius Kelly. Sister Marlene Henderson celebrates on the 16th. Brother Nigel Francis celebrates on the 17th. Sister Nina Clark Brulee and Sister Asta Williams celebrate on the 18th. And Brother Mario Richardson celebrates on the 20th. So we say happy birthday to all of them and to all of those who are celebrating birthday. And if we don't have your name, but you are celebrating a birthday, we say happy birthday to you as well. We invite our celebrants to come forward as we sing our Moravian birthday hymn, "With Thy Presence, Lord and Savior," for a time of prayer and blessing. It's a rather eclectic bunch of persons to have birthday at the same time. One will fix your car, one will tell you where you come from, one will feed you to heaven, and one will entertain you while you're being fed. It's a very eclectic bunch of persons to have birthday at the same time. Let's pause for a word of prayer. Father and God, we thank you for the gift of life, and we thank you for these your children who are and will, we trust, will celebrate another year of life. God, as you have been good to them in the year that is past, we pray, O Lord, that you will continue to shower your favor upon them and that everything they touch will prosper. And Lord, if they do not know you, that they will come to know you as Lord and Savior of their lives. So our prayer today, O God, is that you will bless and keep them, that you will make your face to shine upon them and be gracious unto them, that you will lift up the light of your countenance upon them, and that you will grant them your peace. In Jesus' name we pray, amen and amen. We sing our happy birthday song. I just need to share with the congregation the news that some of you may have heard and are seeking confirmation that yes, we do mourn the loss of Sister Olive Tong, Miss Green's sister. Yes, Sister Olive passed on Wednesday, pretty much the same way that Miss Green passed. She was not feeling well. They took her to the hospital and she died at hospital. And so we keep the family in prayer. I'll tell you what my prayer has been. Lord, this is number three now. I beg you, move on out my church. Please move on out the church, because we would have lost Aunt Coralie in November, Miss Green by February, and Miss Green made sure she walked with she company by taking Sister Olive with her. So that's now the three. And they normally say death. So we've now experienced our three, and I ask the Lord to please take no more. Sorry? It's a leap year. Yeah, I know it's a leap year, but I ask the Lord, even in this leap year, please not take no more. Because we've had all three, but please keep the family in our prayers as well, because now they have to mourn and bury another family member again. Well, it's giving time in the house of the Lord, and so we present the Lord's tithe and of our offering, an offertory sentence from Luke 6 and verse 38. Give, and it will be given to you. A good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over will be poured into your lap. For with the measure you use, it will be measured to you. Luke 6:38. We present our Lord's tithe and our offering. Let us pray. Our Father and our God, we thank you for your many blessings in our lives. And so, God, as you have blessed us in response to your blessing, we bring these our gifts, but we also bring ourselves and ask, O God, that with these gifts, that the men and women will be called into your kingdom. So bless these gifts and bless us all, we pray, in Jesus' name. Amen. Before Brother Emil comes, Sister Cynthia, welcome back. It's good to see you, and it's good to have you with us.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. Let us lend an ear to the concerns of the congregation. We are that our Sunday morning services are mask optional, and we are asked to respect the position of those who choose either to wear or not to wear a face mask or face covering. However, hand sanitization is still necessary as we move into and out of the building. Masks will still be required at funerals. If you would like to sponsor our live stream, you can do so by submitting your name and a contribution of any amount in celebration of a milestone or in remembrance of a loved one. Your name and the occasion will be mentioned as part of our notices and celebration. Submit the information to the church via email at hillofpeace@gmail.com or to Sister Andrea Francis Drew no later than the Wednesday before the Sunday of the sponsorship, and submit the funds to our treasurer, Sister Vanessa Chumney. We continue to give God thanks for the life and service of Acolyte Anita Green. Sister Green served God through this congregation and all the congregations on St. Croix with distinction. The service of celebration and thanksgiving to God for her life, work, and witness will take place this Thursday, April 18th, 2024, with the viewing and tributes at 9 a.m. and service at 10 a.m. May we all take comfort in our memories and knowing that she is at rest with the God she served. In relation to that, we will be having a rehearsal, a choir rehearsal, on Wednesday, April 17th, beginning at 6 p.m. We had mentioned this earlier in prior announcements for those who would like to join in chorus singing for a choir for Miss Green. In honor of her, we will be having that rehearsal on Wednesday, April 17th at 6 p.m. here in the sanctuary. The Women's Fellowship's monthly meeting will be held this Saturday, April 20th, beginning at 10 a.m. Let us also remember that you can continue to submit your gifts of support to the work of the Lord's Church, and you can do it by mailing to Friedensberg Moravian Church, P.O. Box 617, Frederickstedt, VI 00841. Let us continue to give to the Lord's work consistently so that his work may continue. We do have an announcement from the Vice Chairman of the PEC, Reverend Dr. Adrian Smith, and it reads, "Dear brothers and sisters, warm Christian greetings in the name of Jesus, our Chief Elder. The Provincial Board makes the following announcements. The Reverend Georgette John Cotton, who serves as the pastor of the Grace Hill and Cana congregations in the Antigua Conference, has resigned as pastor of the Moravian Church, Eastern West Indies Province, effective April 15th, 2024. The Provincial Board expresses sincere thanks and appreciation to Sister John Cotton for her service to the province since 1995. We pray for God's blessings and favor on Sister John Cotton in the next season of her life. Reverend Bonnie E.B.W. Smith, Provincial Director of Christian Education, Minister of Christian Education in the Antigua Conference, and Superintendent of the Antigua Conference, has been called to serve as Interim Pastor of the Cana Moravian Church in the Antigua Conference, effective April 15th, 2024. Reverend Algernon Lewis, Chairman of the PEC, has been called to serve as Interim Pastor of the Grace Hill Moravian Church in the Antigua Conference, effective April 15th, 2024. And Reverend Erflin Brown has been temporarily reassigned to the Antigua Conference while he awaits the regularization of his immigration status for Trinidad and Tobago. Please pray for Sister Smith, Brother Lewis, and Brother Brown, their families, and the congregation as they answer the call of God in this moment. Counting team members, please note that today's counting team is Team A, and next Sunday is Team B. These are the concerns of the congregation. Please act accordingly where they concern you. As we move into the ministry of the word, the scripture lesson is taken from Luke chapter 24, verses 36 to 48, and will be read by Sister Elaine Spencer, which will be followed by the songs of praise and worship. And the next voice you will hear will be the spoken word brought to us by our pastor, the Reverend Dr. Jeremy B. Francis.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. While they were talking about this, Jesus himself stood among them and said to them, "Peace be with you." They were startled and terrified and thought that they were seeing a ghost. He said to them, "Why are you frightened? And why do doubts arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet. See that it is I myself. Touch me and see, for a ghost does not have flesh and bones as you see that I have." And when he had said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While in their joy they were disbelieving and still wondering, he said to them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of broiled fish, and he took it and ate in their presence. Then he said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Messiah is to suffer and to rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance and forgiveness of sins is to be proclaimed in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things." This is the word of the Lord.
God is good. And all the time, we have to give God some thanks and praise for this rain. Hallelujah. It was very hot. Was it last weekend? It was very hot. So we give God thanks for this wonderful, beautiful blessing. Amen. Let's stand with me as we sing, "Hear My Cry, O Lord, Attend Unto My Prayer." Hear my cry.